All right, welcome everyone. Costin here with more World of Warcraft Burning Crusade Classic Beta. So, I'm gonna go be doing some heroic dungeons and maybe a couple of normal dungeons. We will see how that plays out. Sorry. But of course, I do have some things that I need to do before we get going. Well, one of the things is I need to actually wait for people to come online. That I'm gonna be doing these dungeons with. But the other thing is, okay, copy a link. The other thing is just to link my stream. Hi, question. Do you think the Spurgar shield is worth farming? Nope. I don't think it's worth it at all. I don't think it's worth it for farming. I don't think it's worth it for the sake of leveling either. Okay, I'm just gonna set this up. All right. Well, because for farming, you can use Skull Flame, which gives you a back HP. I mean, I guess Spurgar is the second best one, I suppose.
Hey, Costin.
Yeah, so you got some shadow protection potions, I guess?
Yeah, I'm gonna right now. Give me a sec.
Yeah, I think those will be very useful. I've got other stuff myself, like flasks and all that.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna do flasks, because I was thinking about it, and I'm like, you know, when I'm doing this for real, I'm not gonna have flasks, but I can have shadow.
When you are doing this for real, you have a chance to increase your HP, so that's one thing to bear in mind. Yeah. Dominoes. Okay, let's see if the Twitch stream is working. Just checking that out quickly. Yeah, of course, they are going to wipe the characters, yes. Okay. All right. And also for anyone interested, I am also streaming on Twitch for any person that's interested.
Let me find someone that I know so that they can trade me.
I mean, you could just trade me, no problem. I am in Orgrimmar. You need. Okay. Okay.
Oh, okay, just give me a second. I'm trying to figure it. Because I don't really want to log in the character that actually has him, because she's fully world buffed. So, alpha buff. So, that would not be a good idea. Or, can I just copy Alphaba again? She has in her bag.
I mean, if you delete her, I think. I don't know. Try it.
I don't think I need to delete.
Yeah, just try it. I don't know how it works. I haven't tried copying. I haven't abused the character copy system myself, so I don't know. Can't answer.
Hey, it worked.
Ah, nice. I'm considering just leveling a tune on the beta from 170. I don't know if that's worth it, RhadigarTV, to be quite frank with you. I really don't think it's worth it.
You're gonna like this name.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. Okay, that's a nice one.
Here, and this can help you and me. Yeah, let's go with that.
All right, so I'll give you 5 of the potions and the 1 oil. All good.
And I'll hand the potions out to everyone.
Mm-hmm. Well, I hope you have a healer. Yeah, I'm just gonna head over then to...
We're looking. My healer kind of bailed. I was in tap for the last hour, so I just kind of like logged on to see all the messages.
Okay, it's all fine. It was just kind of annoying with the
Lampa?
I don't know if he is.
Sorry.
It was just kind of annoying, like how we failed on the final boss and Harbinger. Because every time.
Also, have you done?
What?
Have you done the Tablets of Bari quest? I just don't want you to have to do Arcadres again.
Yeah, I have. Oh, I don't care. Like, honestly, I'm not interested in doing the Tunic quest for BT.
Yeah, it was really annoying how he kept wiping.
And there we go. The pre-raid best on slot shield, ladies and gentlemen. 33 badges of justice.
What do you seek?
I'm just going to sell that. Thank you very much. How much is it? 31. So it's actually a 2 less stamina, but the amount of armor they get to this, like 900 armor, almost 1k, really. 2 less defense, but more block. So yeah, this is a significant upgrade compared to what I was using previously. Well, I'm gonna fly to Arcatraz at any rate.
God damn it. There's a group in Arcatraz right now. Fuck them. Damn it.
The Naru have not forgotten us.
Will a Pally heal be good for this?
No. Am I still leaning towards engineering enchanting, someone asking on Twitch? Yes.
A shaman healer would be okay, right?
Yep, that would be perfectly fine. They got nature swiftness, bloodlust, grounding.
Okay. I can't currently. I'm at work just spamming spells. God fucking damn it. Grr.
Yep.
Well, ideally... Hold on.
All right. So one of the things I would say, by the way, yeah, my paladin's guide's been amazing. Thanks for that, Keen. One of the things I would say.
I wish Death Camp would respond to me.
But he's probably sleeping. He's fucked up his sleeping schedule again.
Yeah.
Believe me, you're not the only one irritated with his weird schedule. Right, let's just say that. Okay. He's not online right now, I think.
What'd you say?
I don't think he's online right now.
No, he's not. I'm messaging him on Discord. Why do you think I have all of you friend me on Discord?
So one of the things I would say, by the way, the beta for all of you watching is that for me personally, I don't know how you guys feel about it if you've played it or watched people play, but for me personally, it's reinforced my opinions that I had coming into the beta about like what raid comps are going to be, which tanks are going to be strong, how they're going to be strong, all that kind of stuff. There are some surprises, I would say, for me, like Feral Resto Druids being awful in terms of healing in a 5-man. That's actually a bit surprising because they wouldn't necessarily be the best, but they do have Nature Swiftness, they do have party healing, they do have combat res and all that, so you assume they're really strong. But so far, I've been disappointed by, like, in tough heroic dungeons. Now, it would be easier if we had more HP so we could soak the damage so those HOTs could actually heal us. But, like, in terms of the heroic dungeon progression we've had so far, I think Resto Druids have been a disappointment, to my surprise, actually. Another thing I would say is that Paladin tanks ended up being a heck of a lot more powerful than I thought they would be. Like, even with crap gear, I've done, you know, even with this gear, like, I've done everything that I've thrown myself against. Sure, maybe I used Flask, maybe I used Stone Shield, but I was able to tank Dernhold Heroic, I was able to tank until the final boss in Arcatraz, and those are not easy heroics, right? So far, it has been...
I'm, like, messaging everyone and, like, holding my breath.
Yep. Yeah, it's all fine.
Hey.
Well, we got a hunter at least. That's gonna be nice single target DPS, which I actually need. Now find the Resto Shaman if you can.
Resto Shaman or Holy Priest, correct?
Yeah, one of those two. Preferably Shaman because, you know, bloodlust, but still. I mean, I don't think we need it with a hunter if he's well equipped, because hunters are doing incredible.
Don't get your hopes up. He doesn't have fucking heroic key.
He doesn't have what?
The heroic key.
Oh, rip. Oh, well. It's all fine.
I said, ah, fuck. What rep are you at with Chitar here? Let's see. Maybe he's just an idiot. Shadrux. Let me try to message Shadrux.
Okay, let me see if I can get... Oh, I need to go to Area 52, actually, over here. With regards to, like, the meta, the raid meta, I would say that melee are screwed. Perhaps even more so than I might have imagined, right? Like, I made a lot of those videos on there, so I'm sure it's going to be easier than private servers, but then you find yourself in a situation... Sure, some of the damage and the HP, obviously, is lower, but the boss damage is pretty much on par with private servers, which is, well, a bit of a complicating issue. For melee, though, the mechanics still screw them over, even if the damage is
Well, the good news is everything is single target in this instance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can go for whatever. We don't need AoE, really. I mean, some pack, sure.
Is a warrior okay?
Yeah, perfectly fine. I could use the demo shout. Like, the thing about Curse of Weakness is that at the day, it's like just a single target, whereas demo shout is multiple target, right? But yeah, most
Super Bud. Have you heard of him?
Yeah, I wasn't necessarily impressed by his damage and some of the runs I've had with him, but... I don't know. Oh, you can't run a Fury Warrior. Just don't run four and assume it's gonna work. I think Apes tried to run multiple Fury Warriors for Mag, and... Well... I think, like, didn't the Apes try and run multiple Warriors for the Mag Faradon run, and they failed? So, the lesson of Beta, by the way... Progress and Apes, from my understanding, both Progress and Apes lost... To resist and so, praxis.
Maybe no, that's a rogue. I don't want a rogue.
Yeah. So like apparently progress was slower than resist and than Crix's group, right?
Ah, you're killing me here. Windjammer? Can I ask Windjammer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, ask him.
Are you friends with him? Can I tell him that you're...
He is the guild leader, isn't he? So, yeah, I've done dungeons with him, though. Oh, so it seemed that Shadow Priest mana return... Yeah, Shadow Priest is doing really well so far in the beta. Though, worth saying, they wouldn't have done... Yeah. Shadow Priest wouldn't have done as well without Warlocks giving them the Shadow debuff. So it's like the Fire Warlock dream, dead. The melee stack dream, dead. The bullshit that some people were spewing, dead, dead, dead.
Oh, he's still talking.
Also, this nonsense, some people are like, or the nonsense, like, oh, don't worry about your raid spot if you're a rogue mage.
Could probably do it in 20 minutes. Hey!
Yeah, okay, all good. But he's a LA, so he still needs a healer, I guess. I'm just going to mute myself on Discord, by the way, for a bit.
Cool, that's fine. I think he's a DPS, so I'm going to look for healer.
Yeah, so I think like one of the things I would say, by the way, if you're a mage, well, mage is fine, actually. We did Maggie with quite a few mages, but certainly not the meta. Warlocks are the meta. Hunters are the meta. If we could have gotten more hunters in MacFarden, we would have. It would have made our lives easier, actually. Until one of them fucked up by right-clicking the boss and then while they're trying to click a cube. But the one thing I would absolutely say about the current... like what we've seen so far in the testing, forget your dreams of rogue or Fury Warrior stacking, forget any nonsense of any stuff like that. Maybe raids will take multiple mages at least at the start, because I mean, they're still next geared mages with full tier 3. That's pretty damn powerful in its own right. I mean, Atiash on Warlocks is better because, you know, spell damage, but still. But still, mages are not bad. In fact, I was showing a... In fact, when I was doing a lot of raids on a certain server with... when I was doing a lot of raids on a certain server, in terms of AoE damage, when mages could get in melee, basically, or in close range to Arcane Explosion, they would beat Warlocks in terms of AoE damage. It is the proviso that you need to be able to get into pretty much melee range to do it, but if you can, you can top the damage as mage, or at the very least, easily compete with the Warlocks. And here's the thing, here's the benefit about that, by the way, speaking about mages. The benefit is Arcane Mages have no threat issues. A Seed of Corruption will pull aggro. 10 Arcane Explosions will not pull aggro. And that's kind of one of the big benefits that mages have when it comes to AoE. Now, you don't want to stack them. At most, you might want two. But there's still a pretty sizable benefit in having multiple, in having a major two in a raid, even from that point of view. That shouldn't be completely discounted, as I feel. But any kind of like nonsensical meta about stacking Fury Warriors and Rogues, yeah, take that opinion, wrap it up in nice paper and shove it in the trash can, because that's where it's gonna go. That's dead. That's gone. We've seen it. People with experience said it was a stupid, asinine idea. Fight Club believed, you know, some people on Fight Club, some rogues and all that, believed in the delusion that, oh, it's going to be so easy, we're not going to have to care about it. Well, it's not that easy, as people thought it would. That's the thing. And, you know, this is where I kind of get irritated with a bunch of people that play private servers, and all they can think about, oh, it's going to be easy. But what they don't consider, what they don't do, what very few people have done, is very few people have looked at the fights, analyzed the mechanics, and try and figure out, it's like, what's going to work? What's not going to work? How long is a boss fight going to be? If we assume retail values, and if we assume we're going to be doing the same kind of DPS, how long is a fight going to be? Because if you had done that math, sure, you end up with shorter boss fights, especially in Karazhan, but yeah. Yeah. I suppose, I think 1 melee group with a warrior, with a prowl warrior in that as well will work. How are rep paladins in the beta? In the meta. Well, you probably wouldn't necessarily use one for a speedrunning comp, but you would absolutely use one for a normal raid comp. But that depends on that kind of discussion, though, of rep paladins. The big thing that rep paladins bring to a raid, the most important thing, is judgment of wisdom. So the question with judgment of wisdom, now you can say, well, you know, a prot can do judgment of wisdom. No, you're judging Crusader if you're tanking, because you need a fret. Even though prot paladin fret has been really good, Crusader is still mandatory if you want to keep fret on any particular target. So where Retribution Paladin fits in the meta is it's a third blessing, and it keeps all the judgments up on a target, on a boss. So it's incredibly useful for hunters, because it really boosts their DPS to have Judgment of Wisdom on a target, on a boss target. So it comes down to how much time are we spending on trash versus how much time we're spending on bosses, how difficult are the bosses, how big are the mana concerns, and also how much damage can Retribution Paladins do. For my part, my guild is going to run a rep paladin. And the guild I was in, Resist, that I'm not going to raid in Classic, various reasons, one of which they're... The biggest one is, with only tier 4 at launch, I'm not interested in going in a guild that's going to be that hardcore. But they're also going to run speedrunning. And Varbane is absolutely serious about trying to push his guild in being like a very competitive guild. And I think he'll actually succeed in that. So yeah. Will speedrunning even be a thing in TBC, since the raid and every tier except Sunwell are multiple locations? I mean, you will have speedrunning for each individual raid, right? I mean, you won't have speedrunning for MacFarren, then you won't have fucking speedrunning for Gruul, but you will have speedrunning for Kara, you will have speedrunning for SSC, you will have speedrunning for TK. I think it would be interesting to see if you could have speedrunning for both TK and SSC at the same time, if that could be a thing. But yeah. I think, like, it's going to be separate, though. It's like, you'll have a TK run, and you will have an SSC run, and that's what the speedrunning meta is going to be. But keep in mind, I'm going to stress this out for people watching this. If people assume that the raid, that both Tier 4 and Tier 5, because you are going to do both of them at the same time, once both are out, right? Despite the delay, you're still always going to want to go back to Kara. Or maybe not. Depends on the length. I guess, like, if Kara is out for, like, 6 fucking months, maybe then you won't care. Unless you're really unlucky. But you'll still want to do Gruul. I find it very questionable, based on the tuning that we've seen so far. Because guilds will still want to do Mag. They'll still want to do Gruul. Especially Gruul. Yeah. When it comes to that kind of stuff, I would say that when it comes to raiding, I would say that I think it's highly unlikely with the current tuning that we've seen that guilds will be able to complete and to farm raids in a single day. Good guilds will. My guild managed to do both Black Temple and Mount Hyjal pretty much in a single day, or we were very, very close to it. We couldn't quite manage it, but I was on an extremely overtuned server, but we came close to it. But SSC and TK, in particular, have a lot of trash with really fucking frustrating mechanics that you actually don't find in BT and Hyjal. Anyway, Lucas, 3% crit for everyone in the raid. Yeah, here's the thing about that. I'm a prop paladin, right? I can drop 3 points in precision, which is not a big deal, and I can spend those points and improve Seal of the Crusader. 3% crit is not the retribution-only benefit. But I also want to stress out, I've raided without a ret on 2 private servers because we couldn't find one. Not because we didn't want one, but because we couldn't fucking find one. I wanted a ret when I was running guild, and in Resist, we looked for a ret for quite a long time. Eventually, we found someone that picked up a character we had. We gave him that account, and he played ret for us. And he was in every raid. Like, he was there with 100% attendance. That's how important we viewed it. Do you know why? Because without the ret, the mana is a fucking nightmare to deal with. It's enormous, really. It's enormous for your prop paladin. It's important for your shadow priest. It's important for your boomkin. It's really important for your hunters. Like, very, very important. That's the main benefit. And it far outweighs anything else that it brings. Be it a 2% damaging group, potentially 3% crit if the prop paladin doesn't have it. All of those things are relevancies compared to how important Judgment of Wisdom is. Because a prot can't keep it up. A holy could judge it, but obviously a holy has other shit to worry about, right? By the way, to everyone joining in, thank you for coming in, and we're just waiting for, well, we're waiting 20 minutes to get the DPS room. We're still looking, the guy running the group is still looking for a healer, so this might take a bit. Hopefully we will manage. I think he's a lot more dedicated than I am in terms of making these groups happen. I mean, I just CBA after one point. I've spent way too much time in the beta as far as I see it. Just bothering with groups, not having any hope. Also, he knows more people than I do, so. Holy gonna judge Light. There's also that aspect. Holy kind of wants to judge Light. One, because they can do quite a bit of healing with that, and also because they have... There's some tier set bonuses that improve Judgment of Light. So, yeah. Hello, hello, Johnson. Do you think for tanking dungeons you can go half spell power gear so you can cast more spell, or do you need to... You don't go for strength gear. You go for stamina gear, I guess is the best way to say it. Yep. You go for stamina gear if you're tanking as a paladin. That's kind of the play there. Like, so far in the beta, I would say going maximizing your survivability is absolutely the play. In everything I've done. Except normal dungeons, but like in heroics and raiding, yeah, go max survival. If you have mana issues, Shadow Priests exist, Druids with Innervates exist, Mana Potions, Dark Runes, all that kind of stuff, that's what you do. Even if you have to chug mana potions on cooldown, just keep in mind, you are the best AoE farmer in the fucking game. Stratholme, Scholomance, await, Dark Runes will be in very short supply and will net you a significant amount of gold. If there is some investment required to be able to farm Dark Runes as a prop paladin, be aware of that, but it is absolutely worth it. Will you showcase the solo prop paladin farms? Yeah, sure. Once DPC Classic comes out. I'm not doing it on the beta because, quite frankly, I don't have the gear for it. I could do it, but it wouldn't really be effective right now what I could do in the beta, to be quite honest. Can you still equip two engineering stamina trinkets? I mean, I see no reason why you shouldn't be able to. I can't level the profession right now. But unless they're unique, you can check the database on Wowhead. Actually, let me do that myself. Wowhead. Goblin rocket launcher. I mean, even if you can't equip two engineering trinkets, I'd still say engineering is still the best damn profession. But let me just check. Yeah, it's not unique, so you should be able to. You were able to on retail for the entirety of duration of retail. You should be able to when TBC Classic, no problem. Well, Blizzard has been changing some stuff profession-wise, but that was just crap that was exploitable. Like, oh, you can go jewel crafting and you can equip and you can get jewel crafting... jewel crafting only gems, but then you can drop jewel crafting and keep those gems. Or you can get enchanting and you can keep the... You can enchant your rings, then drop enchanting as profession and still keep your rings enchanted. That Blizzard has been changing crap like that, and for good reason. Because there would have been some really extreme players that would have, like, done that. And then swapped to other professions. That's kind of the issue. Someone was mentioning on Twitch a bit ago, like, you, that they thought Fury could be great for dealing with AoE trash because they're not associated with mana. Here's the problem with that. Fury does a fuckload of fret. And it's such an insane fret that they actually can pull aggro, more so than Warlocks can. Do you know? No. Blizzard has not talked at all about dual spec. It's something the community wants, but it's not something that, it's not something that they've actually talked about in any way, shape, or form. I mean, for my part, when it comes to dual specing, I would just say that I'm not against it. I don't really think it matters all that much to BH, honestly. I mean, 50 gold, oh, it's a gold sink. Dude, you've got people earning 5k gold the week doing GDKP runs in fucking Classic. You want to talk about gold sinks? Fucking hell. it's like, yeah, 50 gold. Like, Blizzard should just put the respec cost zero or 50 silver, or cap it out as it is right now in the beta at 50 silver. Have it something, I suppose, but... doesn't matter if they have it. It's just a bit of a frustration, nothing more. There are add-ons to help you respec. Talents, gear, doesn't matter. Yeah, action bars. I remember having a Fury in TK and his cleave could definitely kill him. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, Fury Warriors, that's kind of the problem. Like, Fury Warriors do a fuckload of damage, but that's their issue. They do a fuckload of damage. Tanks can't keep up. That's the benefit. This is why, by the way, range DPS went out. One of the reasons range DPS went out against melee. One of the reasons is the pure fact that aggro is less of an issue for range DPS than melee DPS, right? With the same fret. Like, with the exact same fret, the melee will pull aggro, ranged won't. Do you think it's going to still craft the jewel crafting trinkets, drop profession, and use those? I don't know, but the jewel crafting trinkets are not that important. So maybe you could, maybe you can't, I don't know. I don't know if they have a jewel crafting requirements. I haven't had the jewel crafter since... Actually, I was one on retail TBC, and that was kind of the only period where I was one. Well, that and Wrath, but still. I don't think the new LFG tool is in yet, right? Nope! There's still a lot of stuff Blizzard hasn't... It still needs to fix in the beta. For instance, one of the problems is that Protection Paladins through Spiritual Attunement don't get mana back when they're when they get heals over time done on them. Hello, hello, Rumble. And to everyone else that's currently joining in, we're still looking for a healer. The eternal struggle of the beta. Finding a healer. This is what it feels like. Blizzard, you done goofed. Like, the thing is, we need to test stuff out in the beta. You know, we've leveled up. We've seen the leveling zones. I'm unmuted. What's up?
Can you ask Wind if he's willing to heal?
Oh, man. Okay, let me try.
Let me try.
Wouldn't Fred be semi-okay? I mean, that's kind of the point that Francois is just saying there. They do not have a Fred dump. Yeah, that's absolutely true. He doesn't have healing gear, Sally. So he...
What do you say?
He doesn't actually have healing gear, I'm afraid.
Oh no.
Yeah. Do you think the healer shortage will be an issue once BC Classic launches on light servers? Yes. Though not necessarily for the sake of max level. I think it's not really going to be a problem necessarily on max level, but it absolutely will be a fucking nightmare while leveling. If you're not part of the Zerg. If you're part of Zerg, fine. But even then, I imagine that actually there will not be enough healers even with the Zerg. Maybe. But I think... are you willing to share your UI profile? Oh, man.
Well, we don't really... There's nothing I can do. There's literally no one on.
Okay, let me shush. Rip. Let's see... I mean, there's 24 people. You're serious? You can't... I mean, I hate to be the guy who says this, but I think you could just try whispering people.
I did. Unfortunately, all of the priests do not have keys because they're slacker. And all of the shamans are preoccupied.
Well, do you want to do another one and that spends us an hour and then we can try then for a group for Architect?
I unfortunately only have an hour and 30
minutes. Oh, okay. Yeah.
That's kind of my dilemma.
Yeah, I don't know what to say then.
That's... Yeah, I have... I unfortunately have something at 4 my time, so I need to get ready for that at 3:15. I need 45 minutes. If we don't do this, then I'll try again tonight. I don't know.
Yeah. Okay, I mean, we could still do another heroic now if you want, to do anything else.
Which one would you want to do? What's the quickest one?
I mean, you pick one. Like, I'm indifferent to any of them. Really.
I pick one.
How about Mana Tombs? Because that's actually a hard one. Like, I want to see Mana Tombs, Eric. Ask those healers if they have lower city keys.
Sure, let's see.
Yeah, how the fuck... Well, the problem is we're looking for people to do Architrast Heroic for, and the problem with that is the rep grind for Shatar is literally the worst rep grind in the game. So that's kind of the problem.
All right, here we go.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, I think once Death Camp comes online, We'll just do it then. And that will be later tonight. Like, I'm fine doing whatever, really. And I'll be on for a bit.
Oh, what's the daily?
I don't know. Let's see. I mean, you check, actually, because you have the easiest transport. And you're already there. Alright. Steam vaults it is then. But yeah, I'll be quite frank with you. At this kind of hour, I really doubt that you will find a lot of people. I've had this issue myself, actually.
It's just frustrating. I just wish Blizzard would not create 76 fucking beta servers and invite two people. To each one.
No, they invited a lot of people. Like, remember how many people there were on the raid testing server? There's thousands of people that are in the beta. They just can't give a crap to level.
There's just too many servers. You know what I mean? Does that make sense?
Why? Because it's...
Like, they should have just did... They should have just did one server in every time zone. Period. Make it a PvP server. Test everything on a PvP server. Fuck PvE. Like, you can do everything that a PvE does on a PvP server.
Yeah, I suppose. As annoying as it would have been to deal with the Ape Squad, I think it would have been better in some way, shape, or form.
And it would have congregated people, so we would have actually had, like, 50 people instead of 25 people.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. It would have helped. But I think what Blizzard should have done is just... I don't think that matters as much as the fact that they are forcing everyone to level and do reputations and all that crap, right? If they kept the Badge of the Justice server open, we'd be doing heroics all day, pretty much. With no problems. And, like, that's the thing. I want to do every heroic dungeon in the game. I want to see, okay, is the scripting right? How's the tanking? How's the healing? All that kind of stuff. That's my interest.
Same.
So, yeah. I'm pretty irritated with Blizzard. Can you share the daily quest, by the way?
I would hope so.
Okay, I'm just gonna... I'm still flying in chat, so whatever. Yeah.
Are you flying to Shadowrock?
Yeah, but whatever. I'm already on my way, so... And the closest 5-point right now is Shat itself, so can't stop that.
Can't stop now. And we can't stop.
All right.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah. It's nice that they finally enabled the stones, by the way. one thing I would say about that.
That was really annoying. It did not work.
My classroom is watching your stream right now. What? How is your classroom watching my stream right now? That's a really interesting one. Okay. So I'm just gonna do salvation on every single person. What is this? Burning Crusade educational class? Sounds amusing. Okay, wisdom on the priest. Projector testing. Can they hear it or can they just see it? Why, well, hello at any rate. No pressure, right?
Alright, let's make this a quick one. Let's do this.
Yeah, let me just trade you the...
Yeah, trade me the ship.
Yeah, let me see it. That's about it, right?
And we'll do this tonight, right?
Yeah, yeah. I'm all fine.
Just save the lockout for me, buddy.
Yeah, don't worry. I'm not gonna get saved. It's not like Arcatraz groups are flying out of... I watched your heroic arc run last night, and I don't want you to think a druid can't heal for the last boss. Phillip, I agree. I don't think that druid was doing a really good job, to be quite honest, but that's fine. You know, people... Like, the one thing that I would say is TBC is going to require an adjustment from people and the way they play the game. And that's normal. That's natural. We've seen it on private servers, like, where people just, like, you know, start to... Oh. Gosh. There's the healing. I think he was maybe drinking. We've seen it on private servers where people that never played TBC suddenly had to confront themselves with TBC rotations and mechanics.
You know, I would have laughed if Lust Hose was like a 70 priest.
I just gotta mute Discord, by the way, for a bit. Just FYI. Just talking with chat. So I feel like when it comes to what the rest of Druid was doing like right last night, and not just him, like other people as well, like the Shaman not purging and all that kind of stuff, not using grounding until we wiped several times, all that kind of stuff. I mean, I think people just need to get used to it. And that's pretty normal. As far as I'm concerned, that's actually going to be one of the main difficulties. One of the things about TBC is it's not easy. Regardless of what a lot of people might say, especially those that have played on certain servers, it's not an easy expansion. There's a reason why it has the reputation as being one of the most difficult in the game's history. I might die. Well, I wonder what the healer was doing there. Please don't kill me. Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Yep. Oh boy. This is heroic, boys and girls. Right, so, yeah. That Sunwell back in the day only cleared 4 bosses. Each boss felt like a crowning achievement. Yeah, I have to... You know, I don't know if I'd agree with that on every boss, but I can tell you one of the things that I am really proud of as a prop paladin is that I tanked Brutalis. It wasn't a hard boss to tank. I mean, anyone, like, it's a very easy boss to tank. But, like, everyone was like, oh, prop paladins can't tank Brutalis. I might die here. Or not. The Warlock did the Curse of Weakness. And the damage is significantly lower as a result of it. Not lower to the point that you can ignore it, but... I think healer was just a bit behind there. I wonder what is this healer doing. Let's see the healing done. Yeah, he is only doing... Yeah, that's one of the things. You don't flash heal. You use greater heal in TPC. So, yeah. Okay. So who's on Discord, by the way? Oh, life is.
The healer.
Yeah. Are you using flash heal, by the way? Or what are you?
Yeah. Playing around with rank.
Yeah, I think you want to use greater heal from what people have told me. From what priests have told me. I just basically spammed it.
I'll improve here.
Oh my god. You have aggro on one of it. On one of them. I'm trying to get it. There we go. If you guys got healing tips, by all means. Yeah. So I think when it comes to healing life, if I think like what some guys I know, what they do is like greater heal, maybe renew bubble the tank, and if the group takes damage, they just circle of healing.
Yeah, that sounds good. Yep. I ranked greater heal two more.
Mm-hmm. Like don't be concerned about mana. The fights will be very short. That's the one thing to know. But like everything hits like a truck. If you guys have healing tips, I'm willing to hear them. Like I think that's one of the things about difficulty in TBC. Like it's gonna take time for people to realize how to heal, how to DPS, and all that kind of stuff. Well, maybe not to DPS, perhaps as much. We haven't had that kind of issue. Patrol over here. Let's deal with it. Yeah. I think it's free targets that you see it on. I think it really is free targets that you see it on at the BH. There we go. But that's my view. You know, I'm kind of tempted to just make a healer myself. You should bubble me more. Honestly, I'm not too keen necessarily myself on getting bubbled. Linus out here. Let me mark these. Yeah, just marking this AoE everything. Kind of wish Windhammer was on Discord at this time. So I can tell him to drop nature protection. Alright, greater heal, prayer amending. That's good. Well, I was the one mostly taking the damage. Alright, let's move up. Nope, wait. Let's see damage done. Alright.
This is a really quick one.
Yeah, Steam Vaults is a very quick, easy one. In fact, it's one of the easiest heroics in the game. I'd say the second easiest. The easiest is Arcanine Crypt's heroic.
Really?
Yeah, because it's like...
I just connected. He said, Def Camp said he'll be on at 6 p.m.
Okay. And what time is it now?
11 a.m.
So 7 hours, okay.
But I'll be on at 7, so in 8 hours we can do it.
Right.
What time is it gonna be at your place?
No worry. Oh! I mean, for me, it's gonna be like... It's gonna be like 6 a.m., but I can try streaming for how many hours? No problem. Or I can go to bed and just wake up then.
Alright, you just take care of yourself.
Okay,
Oh wow, you don't even need me. Okay. Bye guys.
Yeah. Like, bring a warlock, easy mode. Let's go. The depths will consume you. Make sure you guys spread out. When the vortex happens, yeah, move out of it. Easy stuff. Okay.
Our matron will be the end of you.
Easy life. In my opinion, what is the hardest heroic in TBC Classic? I haven't done mana tombs, so I'm not going to express myself until I do mana tombs. Shadow Holes was kind of easier than I thought it would be. What did I say was going to be the hardest heroic? Because I did a video like about the hardest heroics in TBC Classic. I just kind of forgot which one I said it was going to be. I think I ranked Shadow Holes. I think I ranked Shadow Holes high, I ranked Mana Tombs high, I ranked Dirnhold high, I ranked Arcatraz, but I don't remember which one, and Blood Furnace. I just don't remember which one of them I said that was the hardest. I think Shadow Holes was the one. I might eat those words then. But it's kind of tricky to say, because the problem with it is like, yeah, a paladin like myself who has done all of TBC for ages, no, can help trivialize Shattered Halls because I know when to do the pulls and all that, right? And how the mobs are going to behave and all that kind of stuff. I mean, so far, Arcatraz has been really difficult, but I can't exactly carry Arcatraz. Stay back. As I can't exactly carry as much. MGT is not really a heroic you lump in with the rest of them. I mean, I did make that point in my video. If you're asking what the hardest heroic is in TBC, then yeah, MGT wins by mile. Easily. Simply because MGT is a heroic designed for people with tier 6 gear to struggle with at some point, and we did when it came out and we were trying to do, you know, to get our trinkets. It certainly was something of a struggle to do. He does have salve. How does this feel compared to Shattered Holes and Arcatraz?
I mean, Shattered Holes was not too bad with our comp, right? And I think everyone did a good job. And I think her group is full for tonight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll, I mean, if you're talking about, like, 6 hours, 7 hours from now, sure, I'll be there.
Yeah, 7 p.m., so that would be 8 hours from now.
Mm-hmm.
So Windjammer, you, me, mm-hmm. Death Camp, and hopefully Homie Baron.
All right.
Because he's my helmet.
Yeah, all good. If death count.
Oh! Hit rain. Got you.
What'd you say?
I should be asking for more curse of weaknesses.
Oh, you almost lost.
Yeah, the damage is no joke. One of the things I found as a tank so far is that I don't have to care about Frey, but I do have to care about survivability. Well, crush immunity. Am I crush immune? Well, crush immunity doesn't matter for heroics. It matters for raiding, of course, but not for heroics. Because obviously these guys aren't high enough level. Like, these are just level 70, they can't crush me. Mobs need to be of a certain level to be able to crush you. Do you guys have 14 Myrmidons? What is that? Holy shit, that quest. That's a bit much. I guess we'll have to clear all of this place of Myrmidons. Can you pull that? Actually, wait. Just follow.
Yeah, just follow.
We'll just follow it. Don't pull yet. Don't pull.
Now we can.
Yep, this is fine. Just as long as we don't pull the slaves. Oh man, Sephic holds heroic.
You know what? This turned out even better. This is a quick one. I have so much time to prepare for my agent right now.
Mm-hmm.
I have to sing for an agent today. So.
All right. Oh, you're a singer.
I'm an actor, singer, dancer. I do musical theater professionally in New York.
So. I see.
So. This gives me time to warm up my voice, because I am not at my best today.
Well, you stayed up until late last night, so yeah.
I stayed up way too late because I thought I was going for the agent on Wednesday, and then I found out that they changed the schedule 2 days ago.
Well, rip. That's sad.
Yeah.
Seed go boom. Regarding world tanks letting...
It's okay. I'll be fine. This is not the first time. And at least I wasn't drinking last night, so there's not...
No, you were just doing Arcatraz and wiping on the final boss. It's,
Did you, like, hear how tired I was getting? I was like...
Dude, yeah. I mean, it's like, I know. It's like, you were barely staying awake. I've been there. All right, this one, easy. Very easy. I'm just going to wait 10 seconds for the reduced armor to go away, and then we can pull.
You don't have to say easy, it's team vault. easy mode.
Builds the ads.
Well, his seed should be enough to do that.
Yeah. Absolutely. Cooldown on Bloodlust. Oh, we've been that fast. Okay. No problem.
Yeah, right now we've only been in here for 24 minutes, FYI.
Mm-hmm. I want to do the dungeon by the way. So I need to kill more, like six more Naga. Yeah. Myrmidons.
Okay. Also, did you get the daily?
Yeah, that's the dungeon quest. The normal daily, right? Yeah. I would share it, but it's kind of pointless for me to do so right now, because you're not gonna... Well...
I don't think you can share
it. Oh, you're right. You can share it. Rip. Oh, so sad. You actually have to go to chat yourself and pick it up.
Can I tell you something? I'm so sad that you can't share it. Oh my god, it hurts my feelings so much. No, I don't give a fuck.
How's heroic black morass? I can't say right now.
I just, you know what's so not motivating about this? It's just, I feel like tomorrow they're just going to pull the rug out without telling us.
What are they going to pull the rug?
Like end classic and just, that's it. Also, we don't have to clear any extra mobs. Like, they're all in here. There's two right here. There's going to be another two in the door.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, two here, two up, two in the door. And, yeah, that should be fine. You're right. So you actually do get the number of mobs required just for a single run.
Yeah.
I'll be frank. I don't care about heroic black morass in any way, shape, or form. As far as I'm concerned, that place is a heroic that you should never bother with in the entirety of TBC. That's gonna hurt. Help me. Oh, can you get that heal?
Oh, fuck, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I can get this one. Oh, you got it. Great. Now I'm on cooldown.
It's fine. Oh, win hammer. Alright, stay here. Get to full. I'm gonna pull him back. The two-hand sword that's weaker than many other swords in the game. Yeah. Well, I didn't tell the warlock to do curse of weakness on them, because I think the healer can keep me up. Just throw a heal on the warlock and I'm pulling. I'm coming.
I'll blizzard around the corner. Oh, heal me, Yuri. Does Windhammer have Ankh? He has Ankh. Okay, let's go.
I mean, you can get the other blacksmithing weapon, the sword, the axe, all that kind of stuff. All of them are good. Obviously, Deep Thunder is the best.
We are fine. Whatever.
Just one tiny wipe. That's kind of the thing. Right now, the beta. You need healers that have a degree of experience.
How did he get the Illidari tabard?
You just do the quest.
What quest?
There's a quest in Shadowland Valley. I think
Which
it's Path of Conquest or something like that. Or some.
conquest.
Yeah. Or something, anyway. Oh, there. Okay, I think it's an NPC at the end of the Path of Conquest that you help out, and that quest gives you the Deladari tablet, I believe. There's an imprisoned Naru. Not Naru, Draenei. Anyway, let's go. Oh, man. Okay. Well, you can use Gore Howl, or you can use the Gruul Axe if you want to. But obviously Deep Thunder is going to be the best weapon.
Yep, perfect. 14.
Yep.
I'm going to give you a second for threat before I start, because they're just beating me up. Because my blizzard makes an insane amount of threat.
Alright. I'm just... actually, go back. Because I'm going to pull this one back as well. And I want to be sure that we actually have space here. Oh, silenced. The problem I have is... I mean, yeah.
Caster in the back.
I mean, line of sight, mate. That's why we did, why I ran back. Okay, I'm gonna try taunt. There are some things I'm gonna hold against people. Not line of sighting when the tank is deliberately pulling back for that very purpose is actually one of those. Well, it's all on YouTube. Not knowing your rotation into a TBC beta, fine. Not knowing how to line of sight.
Lightning bolts in a frost shot.
Not knowing to line of sight, so the tank could pull threat with consecration and then just casting spells. Not fine at all.
It's got a little spicy near the end. Or as I like to call it, spicy.
That is Shadow Labs.
Shadow Labs is fun.
Yeah,
Shadow
I agree.
Labs is fun. Like, yes, it was long. It was hard. Kind of
well,
like my grinder
preference.
It would have
been easier if Care didn't keep shooting his rocket launcher all willy-nilly.
Care is just a horrible tank that doesn't follow instructions. Listen, I tried to lead the first time I met Kostin because I've never really played with him, and then Kostin was smarter than me, so I stopped leading. Care, I'm smarter than Care. You should just listen to me.
Okay, let's just go. Put Let's go.
Are you running in?
Yeah. I am running in. Oh, mommy. That's gonna... Oh, baby. Heal.
Interrupting. Good. Got it.
Well, I managed that at the very least. There we go. We're in a hurry.
That was nice.
Okay.
Quest complete.
All right. Right. Let's go.
You deem yourselves worthy simply because you bested my god. Your head will roll. I'll work
here. No, not. Here we go. Okay, tank,
this
nuke it.
Is not nearly over.
Oh. You have blood loss after this.
He said he would. He was gonna wait after the first reflect. Yeah, don't kill yourselves, by the way. There we go, nuke. Doing this with a full caster group, not necessarily the wisest idea, I gotta say. I suppose. At least for this boss. Everything else has been fairly trivial with this group, but yeah, it just kind of makes this boss longer than it has to be because he does have that spell reflect ability. Spell reflect.
Of course, the one.
Tank.
This is not nearly over.
Good. Okay, spell reflect is down. Good. What do I think are going to be the best profession for a poly paladin? Tailoring, leatherworking? Maybe? I don't know. You have choices. Alchemy, maybe. You do have options as a holy paladin. That's the thing. You're not really pigeonholed. Initially, maybe tailoring, but I don't know if I would say that's new. Just keep nuking him.
There we go.
Oh, good job. That's done. I'm gonna take that gem. Let's of the bolt. But yeah, you have choices, I'd say, as a holy paladin. That other people just don't have, to be quite honest about it. So I think. I'm gonna put that in the pants.
Mike, I'll help you get the key. Sometime that I'm not running like mad dog.
Yeah, you're good. I was just gonna go find a group of ambush dungeons.
No, right, do you wanna do Botanica and Mechanar? How much rep do you need?
I just hit honored with Shatar.
Yeah.
First, okay. I was gonna go respec Shadow. I looked up the guide to do it. There's a few quests I haven't done that I could go do, and then once I get to like 9,000, then I'll go and finish it off.
I think as a healer, you can make your own groups, and you would find people for it pretty easily. That's the biggest shortage of people right now, healers, right? So, but yeah, you can also quest. But the single Botanica run is like 2k rep. Okay. Well, I'm down to doing another heroic if you guys want, if you want.
I'm out.
Yep, see ya.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Oh, I have keys for Thralmar, Lower City, and Coil Fang. Yeah, but I kind of want to get my Shatar rep. I think I'm just going to do that.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Well, how about just we do a Botanica, then we do another heroic, then? I admit I'm not necessarily fond of doing back-to-back Botanicas for rep, but...
Okay, yeah, I'm down for that.
Yeah, let me just see who I can get. Okay, so gonna do a Botanica normal, help the priest out get his rep.
Choose wisely.
Shireloran.
Later. What time is it anyway? Well, it's 9:28, right? My time. You already know, make friends, tanks and healers, find one another and pair up, just don't blame the kids for the divorce. Okay. I just need DPS.
Warm wishes to you. Dionysus.
Well, oddly enough, there's no DPS either. What the hell? Yeah, there's only 17 people. Many of them are in. There's 5 people.
It's been a struggle lately to find group.
Yeah, I think a lot of people just CBA playing the beta. And I mean, there are still some people leveling, but obviously they're not going to have the rep, right?
Right. It seems like the first round of 70s after the raid server finished just kind of disappeared.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I mean, I know people that are in the beta that I raided with, and they won't bother leveling because they CBA. Thanks, Blizzard! If you're watching, Blizzard, please give us pre-made 70 characters on
yeah,
the
beta. I wanted to level on the beta because I know I'm going to be grinding dungeons yeah. in live.
Well, I mean, there are plenty of people who are like, why would I spend my time leveling in the beta, right?
When it's just going to get deleted anyway, right?
Yeah.
I had fun.
Alright, there's the quest. Consortium Cenarian Expedition. Consortium Cenarian Expedition. Rep. I've been healing in the beta. You know, it used to be that I could get full... Like, the problem with DPS, I think, that's become in the beta, that's happened in the beta right now, is really just the fact that... It used to be, like, when you were trying to form a group, you would get, like, 3 DPS instantly. And then you would spend an hour trying to find the healer. But now it's like, you can find healers, surprisingly. You can actually find healers in the beta. That's not really as much of an issue anymore. But you can't fucking find a DPS L. Well, that's kind of sad. I'll give it a go for like 10 minutes or so. If not, well, there's just not people online. It's because the healers have leveled up. They were DPS while leveling. I suppose it makes sense, Mederic. You're not wrong, I guess. Although it was kind of weird the fact that we could not find a fucking healer while leveling.
You see this group in Slave Pen? Warrior, Warlock, Triple.
Yeah, I'd kind of see it, yeah. Yeah, I don't. 69 Warlock wants to join Botanica Normal. I'm like, okay, dude. I'm not even going to reply to his message because it's like, he clearly doesn't know. You need a damn fucking mount. Let's see how many people are 70. Yeah, I'm not. I think it's a lost cause right now to try and find people.
Between me and you and the 5 people in Slave Pen, that leaves us with 10.
Yeah. And they're not replying. Yeah. Some are quests.
Oh, it's cool. I'm going to finish these quests and then I'll catch up with you guys later.
Yeah. I'll be around. Okay. All right, boys and girls. Disappointment aplenty, but at the very least I did the Steam Vault's heroic, but yeah, that's what it's gonna be. I suppose I got invited by someone to, hey, let's do Architrass Heroic. I have a healer in a group, and then the healer bailed, then we can find someone, so we did. And he had limited time on his end, so yeah. Kind of nasty situation over there. But welcome to the TBC beta. I am going to do an Architrass with Mr. Deathcamp when he wakes up. or when he shows his face in the evening. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. For now, yeah, time to start leveling your Resto Shaman. I am not... You know what? I think I might just level Resto Shaman for the sake of actual TBC Classic, but I am not doing that in the beta. To be quite frank about it, I never... but right now, it's not even an issue of healers, right? I have a healer that's willing to, you know, do some heroics and all that kind of stuff. The issue is just there's no DPS right now, so... Know about Warrior. When TBC Classic finally launches, where are you going to be streaming? Well, I'll be streaming Twitch. I'll be streaming YouTube. I mean, I am streaming on Twitch right now and on YouTube at the same time. Check out my Twitch channel. Just give me a second. Let me find it. There we go. Check out my Twitch channel, just linking it on YouTube. Check it out. Subscribe if you want to, boys and girls. So, yeah. Another early morning stream incoming. Yeah, it seems like it, unfortunately. So they said 7 p.m. Eastern time, I guess. Or, yeah. Right now it's 11, so they said 8 hours. So, yeah, I'll set up. What time? Oh, what time will I be streaming? When TBC Classic comes out, on the first week of it, I'll probably be streaming for the vast majority of the day, but I'll probably be streaming, like, European hours until, like, midnight Europe. From early in the day till midnight, basically, every day. When things calm down, that's usually going to be my time, so it's, like, going to be, like, 4 or 6 p.m. Eastern European time until 12, yeah. Yeah, I'm obviously going to return to normal hours. But yeah, boys and girls, for now, I'd say that's going to be it. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe, like, enable notifications, and stay tuned for more because there is more happening. I'm going to set up a stream schedule for in about like 7 hours and we'll see what happens. Hopefully, I actually get people, but there's no guarantee in that. Do you think pre-patch will be on the PTR before it drops? Maybe. It's not ready. Maybe. We'll see. I think it makes sense to have the pre-patch on the PTR, so yeah, we'll see. Do I need an account separate from NA to play you? Yeah. Well, you need... I don't know how that works, actually, at this point of BH.